Hey friends, today we're going to talk a little bit about component properties. Now, first of all, what the heckity heck is a component property? Great question. So glad you asked. Component properties are properties of your component, great name, that allow you to assign names and values within your component that can be customized. So there's three different component properties. The one that I use probably the most often is the Boolean property. That's essentially allowing you to turn something on or off, true or false, yes or no. Then there's the text property that allows you to be able to change the text right from within the side panel. And then there's the swap instance property. So if you have, say, like an icon within your component and you want to be able to change it to a pre-selected icon, you can add those within your preferred icon values and you'll know exactly which ones you can select there. So that can be super handy, especially in things like buttons and things like that. So let's take a look at the difference between just using variance and variance and component properties. Because if you're like me, when component properties first came out, you're like, this seems like a lot. I don't want to do this. I'm just going to ignore it. And I wish that I had ignored it because it really is, it's life-changing, people. It's life-changing. But actually, it's really, really helpful. So on the left, you have some buttons that are only made with variants. And on the right, you have buttons that are made with variants and component properties. So you'll see on the right, there's less buttons. And that's because on the left, we had to have a variant for without icon and with icon. And same thing for the secondary button here. On the right, we've been able to use just this one button and tell this icon here to either be shown or not shown, true or false. And that might seem like, okay, that's great. You were able to get rid of a couple buttons here. That's not a big deal. It might not seem like a big deal when it's maybe a smaller set, but once you start to get into, maybe you have a button with no icons and one on the left and one on the right, and then you want the ability to have one on the left and the right, and then you have secondary of all of those, and maybe you even have tertiary. Here, we've gone from 32 variants with just primary and secondary in all the states to 8 variants with using component properties. So you can see how the bigger your component set gets, the more convenient it is to use component properties. And it's not just the Boolean property. Remember, I said there's two other properties. And how can that be helpful? So if I have these two buttons here, this one's made with just variants, and this one's made with variants and component properties. If I were to tell you, okay, change the icon to one that's been pre-selected for approval by your team, and then change the text on the button. If I go into the one that's just been done with variants, I don't know which one's been pre-selected. I'd probably have to go find a list somewhere and then go into my icon and then try and find that icon by going back, blah, 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 blah. So it's not really possible to find a pre-selected one. If I want to change the text, I can double click in there. That's not too bad. But on this one, if I want to find one that's pre-selected, changing my icon, right here, I've got a component property set up. And when I click on that, I have my preferred values set up right here. So my team's already set those up for me. So I know that these are the ones that I'm okay to use on my button. So we'll switch it to the cancel icon. And then if I want to change the text, I can do that right here. And the text especially can be super helpful when you have a lot of text that you want to change. So you don't have to keep kind of doing that either command click or double clicking in to change all the text right here. It's really handy to have everything in one place. So another thing you might be saying now is, okay, Lauren, fine, you've convinced me, but I literally just made all of my variants. I don't want to remake all of these with component properties. Don't worry. It's not too hard. There's an easy way to kind of convert things over to component properties. So let's go back over here. And we want to make our icons, instead of having the no icon button, we want to make this into a component property. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to double click on this icon and you'll see this icon show up right here, an icon on the icon. And this is telling me now to select all matching layers. When I click that, it selects all my icons here. And now you can see on the right side of my screen, either this instance swap property or create Boolean property has shown up. And we're gonna do Boolean property first. And we're gonna click that and I'm gonna do changes to show icon and keep that as true. That's great. Now we have a show icon property. And now you'll see this one that we had is true or false. We can just get rid of that. And then we can even just get rid of these icons right here because we've already made this icon now set to be true or false. And when I pull this out now, the show icon is still there just as we had it toggleable before, but we've been able to delete all these extra components that we don't need. And while we're in here now, we can also go back to here, select all, and add in that instance swap property that we wanted. So let's call this icon again, and we're gonna add in our preferred values. We'll just put couple of these on here and create property. And now again, we'll see this over here. This is allowing me to change this. And another thing that you can do is if you feel like these are not in the right order that you want, maybe you want this one to be above or however you want it to be, you can swap those around and put them in the order that you want them to be. And then the final thing we'll do, just because we're here, is update the text on here to be a property as well. So I'm gonna, again, select all. And I can either do, I don't want to do the layer because I always want there to be text there. So instead of a Boolean property, I'm going to come down to here and do a text property. And this one, I'm just going to call label, and the value is label. If I were to change this in here, so maybe I want this to the default actually to be welcome. Now it's going to create the property. It also changed all of that for me. So it's a great way to change all that text if you want it to be that way. And now when I'm in here, I can easily go in and change this to hello, and my text is changed. So now I can swap it to a different icon. I can actually turn the icon off, and everything that I made before, as far as the primary and secondary, that all still stays. I don't have to change any of that. So it's really a lot easier than it might seem from the beginning to just kind of add in those component properties, even when you've already made the variants. Hopefully that helps and you can get to component propertying. Yay, bye.